Hi folks, Doc Jake from Sioux Nation Ag Center here. Spring is sprung, and we know that one thing that happens every spring that we all do.
Spring cleaning!
No, not that thing. I mean vaccinating calves. In the springtime, we vaccinate our calves because it leads to less disease on pasture all summer and better health when they go into the feedlot in the fall.
So when it comes to vaccinating calves in the spring, there's two main categories of things I want to make sure we get covered. First of all, we want to vaccinate for pneumonia. So we want to protect from pneumonia, and in particular, I want to make sure we're covering the virus BRSV. That's bovine respiratory syncytial virus. You can use an intranasal product like this one. There's some data out now that say injectable products work very well in calves that are about 2 months of age going to grass. But the big thing I want to cover for the pneumonia aspect is a product that has BRSV coverage in it. Now, if you're trying to cover summer pneumonia in calves and the BRSV alone products aren't working, one thing we need to consider is we might also have Mannheimia hemolytica occurring in that herd as well. Pastorella pneumonia is another name for it. You're going to want a product that is given in addition then to cover that type of pneumonia. That can be like this, that's just straight Mannheimia hemolytica product. Or it can be a combination like this that actually has BVD in there. So the other type of vaccine that we're going to want to make sure that we get into these calves is a 7-way. A 7-way covers for 7 different types of clostridials. The big one that I think about when I think about 2-month-old calves is the Clostridium perfringens, type C and D, enterotoxemia, bloor eating disease. They're all kind of the same names for the same thing. We see that a lot in calves of younger age in particular, if they still are going to be on dirt for a little while before they go out to grass. And then of course, blackleg is also good to cover as well. Now, when it comes to using a 7-way in calves, I generally prefer to use a 2cc product rather than a 5cc product. The reason is that the 2cc product is usually a little easier on the calf, which means that you're gonna have a better response as far as weight gain is concerned. Now, the exception comes in is if you're gonna band the calves at the same time. If you're band castrating, you really need a tetanus vaccine. And what's available on the market at this period in time, that's a 7-way with tetanus, which technically makes it an 8-way if we think about it, they're all 5cc products. So not banding, don't worry about tetanus, go with 2cc's. Banding, gonna have to have tetanus, gonna have to go with a 5cc vaccine.
So you may have questions about other things you can vaccinate calves for in the spring.
Hey Doc, I want to vaccinate for pink eye, coccidiosis, bad breath perhaps.
Whoa, wait a minute. We've got some other stuff we need to consider before we start giving all these shots.
The first thing we've got to consider is a calf's immune system. It has only a limited capacity to process every vaccine and mount an effective immune response to it. That means that if we give too many vaccines, we won't be making the calf immune to all those diseases. We could actually potentially make the calf sick. This is especially a problem with vaccines that contain endotoxins. So an endotoxin is a naturally occurring toxin that occurs in the different types of gram-negative bacteria that cause diseases in calves. When we make a vaccine against a disease that causes an endotoxin, a lot of times we end up with a small amount of that endotoxin naturally occurring in the vaccine. If we mishandle the vaccine, it's more likely we're going to have a problem with that endotoxin. Problems may also occur when we give too many of these endotoxin vaccines at the same time. This is called endotoxin stacking. To illustrate the stacking of these endotoxin vaccines, we will use these glasses of water and this lovely cow mug as an example. The calf has the capacity to handle a couple of these vaccines. However, giving more than 2 can cause problems. We can see calves feel depressed or have a fever, or even go off feed. In the worst cases, we can see calves collapse or even die. If you must give more than 2 types of endotoxin vaccines, split it into 2 separate shoot trips, or you may end up with this problem.
Oh no!
In short, spring calf vaccination is very important. However, we want to make sure we're doing it in a way that ends up helping the calves' immune system, not overloading them. If you have any other questions, feel free to reach out to one of us at Sioux Nation Ag Center, where we can help you with not only what products to use, but being able to get those products for you. Thanks and take care.
So you may have some other questions about things you can vaccinate calves for.
Hey Doc, I want to vaccinate... Start again.
Okay. Oh, so your shadow's not showing. Yes. Okay.